నేను మాత్రం మా ఇద్దరు పిల్లల్ని క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందించే ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీ స్కూల్లో మాత్రమే చదివిస్తాను. ఇలా అన్ని ఉన్న చోట మన పిల్లల్ని చదివిస్తేనే వాళ్ళకి మంచి భవిష్యత్తు ఉంటుంది.
నాకు అన్ని నెంబర్ 1 ఏ కావాలి. అందుకే నా పెద్ద మనవరాల్ని అన్ని వసతులతో క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందిస్తున్న స్కూల్లోనే జాయిన్ చేశాను.
ఏ స్కూల్ సార్ అది?
ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీ స్కూల్. క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లో నెంబర్ 1, కల్చరల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ లో నెంబర్ 1, స్పోర్ట్స్ లో నెంబర్ 1, క్యాంపస్ లో నెంబర్ 1.
అది
మీ పిల్లల బంగారు భవిష్యత్తుకు మాది బాధ్యత.
హాయ్ చిల్డ్రన్, టుడే ఐ వాంట్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ కోఆర్డినేషన్ అండ్ లింకింగ్ సిస్టమ్, ద లింకింగ్ సిస్టమ్. వాట్ ఈస్ కోఆర్డినేషన్? ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, సపోజ్ యూ వాంట్ టు వాక్, సపోజ్ మేబీ వాంట్ టు రన్, యూ వాంట్ టు ప్లే. Suppose I want to explain the lesson. I'm handling this duster. I'm writing on the board. So many actions we are doing everyday life. And for example, it is very difficult to stand on our 2 feet on a narrow base. Then what do we do? We balance our posture. To balance our posture, what are the systems involved in this we are discussing now? It's not enough to the muscular system and the skeletal system to balance our posture. Some more system is there involving in our body, that is called as, what do you call it as, the nervous system. Next, what are the parts involved in the nervous system? The brain, spinal cord, and the nerves. First of all, we have to recollect why should we coordinate. Why should the body parts should be coordinate with each other when we are doing the work? Means, for example, the ability of the, do you know children what is a stimulus? Stimulus means a sudden change in our atmosphere. For example, suppose if it is so hot, means what do we do? We get into the house. If it is a heavy rain, means what we do? We go into a shelter. Otherwise, a cat is chasing the rat, means what it will happen? The rat will move away. If the rat does not move, means what will happen? The rat will catch the cat. That means it will not live. Means the organisms, it is the ability to a particular situation to respond. It is to respond particular stimulus. The organisms should be respond to a particular stimulus. It is very very essential for that stimulus, for that response. The nervous system is very very important for us. For example, brain, spinal cord, and nerves. Before going to learn about the brain, structure of brain and the spinal cord and the nerves, we have to learn about the structure of nerve cell. See children, this is the nerve cell, and this nerve cell is where are these nerve cells will be present? Means mostly throughout the body, more than 10 billion nerve cells will be present throughout the body. It is having the cell body with a nucleus, and in the cell body granules will be there. These granules are called as Nissl granules, and this cell body is having the small projections are called as dendrites, and one side the projection is becoming long. This long projection is called as axon, and the dendrites, Nissl granule and nucleus. What are the parts of the cell body? Parts of the cell body is the nucleus, Nissl granule and the dendrites. And the dendrites on side, they are extending. This is called as axon, and this axon is surrounding with covered with a myelinated sheath. So this is called as myelinated sheath. And here and there, the regular intervals, there the gap is there. These gaps are called as node of Ranvier, and these myelin sheath is made up with Schwann cells, and the nerve terminals will be there at the end of the nerve cell. And then where they are present means mostly throughout the body, more than 10 billion nerve cells are present. What is the use of these nerve cells means? They communicate the messages from body parts to brain, brain to body part. Whereas, see children, these nerve cells having connection with throughout the body, what we discussed means throughout the body the nerve cells will be present, isn't it children? Then the dendrites of the cell body having connection with the axon of the nerve cell. See children, this is the cell body is having connection with the axon of the nerve cell. And this union is called as synapse. What do you call it as synapse? What it will mean, sir? What is the use of the synapse? Mainly found on the brain, spinal cord, and around the spinal cord. Where it will present means mainly brain, spinal cord, and around the spinal cord. What is the use of the nerve cell, children? It carries information throughout the body, and the synapse, where the cell body, the dendrites of the cell body having connection with the axon of the cell body. And see children, axon to cell body. The union of dendrites with the axon, nerve terminals, is called as a synapse. What is the use of the synapse means? It carries information from body parts to brain and brain to body parts. How many nerve cells will be there means more than 10 billion nerve cells will be present on the in the throughout the body, which carries information from body to brain and brain to body parts. Next, how many types of nerve cells are there? Okay children, nerve cells are two types, sensory neurons and motor neuron. Sensory neuron is also called as afferent neuron, which carries information to body parts to brain, and motor neuron. It is also called as efferent neuron, which carries information to motor nerves to which carries information from brain to body parts. Sensory neuron. It is also called as afferent neuron. Carries information to body parts to brain, and motor neuron or efferent neuron carries information brain to body parts. And associated nerves. What are associated nerves means? They are connection between sensory neurons and motor neurons. See again, once again, see children. These are the sensory neurons and these are the motor neurons having connection with body parts to brain. And motor neurons are having, they pass information from brain to body parts. Next, associated nerves, different nerve pathways, associated nerves. Brain to spinal cord, where it will grow means afferent nerves, motor neurons. Brain to spinal cord, muscles of the organs. Then what do? We do our work. It will give messages through efferent neurons to our body parts, then we will do our work. Then, if we want to give any information to the brain means muscles, if you want to do the any work means muscles of the organ give information to sensory organs, sense organs through where it will go to brain. Then, these two are muscles of the efferent nerves and afferent nerves are connecting, having connection with the association nerves, different nerve pathways. Don't forget children, efferent neurons carries, bring messages from brain to body parts. Efferent neurons, otherwise sensory nerves, sensory organs too, sensory nerves, they carry messages from body parts to brain. Then brain will analyze and give signals to the body parts through efferent nerves, then only we will do our work. For example, now I am explaining the lesson. That means my brain is giving signals to me to explain the lesson here. Then what do you do? You listen the lesson. Then then your brain will give message to, there is a lesson is there in the online. Then you observe the lesson. This is because of the signals of the brain. If brain is not working means what we will do? We are unable to do anything. If the brain is not giving any signals to the body, means we are unable to do any work. How brain will give these signals to the body parts? Through spinal cord. So we are mentioning the parts of the nervous system, means brain, spinal cord and nerves. Brain give signals through efferent nerves through via spinal cord. Spinal cord is very very important organ to carry information or to carry signals to the body. Okay children, till now what we have discussed children? We discussed about the nerve cell, types of nerves, and in which way we are getting messages, and in which way the brain getting signals from the body parts we have discussed. Here we are going to learn how many types of nervous system is there, means central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system consists of brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system consists of remaining parts of the throughout the body. The nerves will be present. This is called as the peripheral nervous system. Now we are discussing about the brain and the spinal cord. Brain is present in the cranium. A hard bony structure, skeleton, is called as the cranium. It is protected by cranium. And then after that, the brain is having three layers called as meninges. Meninges, for example, and these meninges are from brain to spinal cord. These layers will cover. For example, each very very important organs are there in the body. That is the heart, lungs, and the brain, and the kidneys. Heart is covered by the layers. Lungs are covered by the layers pleura. Brain is covered by meninges. And kidneys also covered by the layers. And heart is covered by pericardial membrane. And lungs are covered by pleura. And brain is covered by meninges. These, what do that means? Pericardial membranes. These, in between these pericardial membranes, cerebrospinal fluid will be there in the brain. Pericardial fluid will be there in the heart, which are very very essential for, they protect the heart from mechanical jerks. Then what is the use of these meninges? Means these meninges, in between these meninges, what will be there? Means cerebrospinal fluid. What is the use of this cerebrospinal fluid? Means it protects the brain from mechanical injury. So for example, if any person is met with an accident, means first of all, this mechanical injury protects from mechanical injury. Any shocks, jerks, if it happened, means it protects the brain. Do you know, children, how many cells are made up with the brain? Brain is made up with more than 10 billion cells, and in each cell there will be cell organs will be there. They will do their respective functions, and the brain will perform their functions. For example, what will be there on the brain? Nerve cells will be there. Mostly the nerve cells will be there on the brain. What are the nerve cells? Mostly the dendrites will be there, axons will be there, the nerve terminals will be there. What do? They carry information to body parts, to brain, and brain to body parts. Then if you observe the structure of brain, mostly, if they observe the structure of brain, brain is divided into three parts: forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. What will be there in the forebrain? Forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. What is the function of the forebrain? Now we will see. What is the function of the midbrain? Now we will see. What is the function of the hindbrain? We will see. First of all, in this forebrain, olfactory lobes are having connection with the forebrain. Olfactory lobes. What is the use of the olfactory lobes? Olfactory lobes are meant for to know about the sense of smell. Next, here cerebral hemispheres will be there. Cerebral hemispheres will be there. What are the parts involved in this forebrain? Cerebral hemispheres, hypothalamus, thalamus. Cerebral hemispheres, hypothalamus and thalamus. In this cerebral hemispheres, the folding like structures are there. The folding like structures are there. Folding like structures are there. See, elevations and depressions. Elevations and depressions. Elevation means which can project outside. Depression means which come inside, which move towards inside. The folding inside is called as, inside the brain is called. And elevation, this is called depression, and the elevation is called as, elevation is called as gyri, and the depression is called as sulci. Elevations and depression, the foldings will be present mostly in the forebrain. And this is the forebrain. This all this part comes under forebrain. All part is called as forebrain. This part, this talk-like small region is the midbrain. And here this is the downward portion. This is the hindbrain. And this is the pituitary gland. What is the use of the pituitary gland here? Pituitary gland is the master gland. Why it is called as master gland, pituitary gland? Whenever the secretions of the hormone is regulated by this pituitary gland. We already know that what are the hormones which are released in the activities, metabolic activities. Pituitary gland is the master gland, where it is controls the secretions of the hormones which are very very essential for the perform metabolic activities of the person. How many parts are there? Forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. And this is the hindbrain. And this is the spinal cord. Now we will learn about the what is the function of the forebrain and what is the function of the midbrain and what is the function of the hindbrain. And what is the function of the spinal? Okay, children, brain is divided into three parts: the forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain, and then olfactory lobes will be connecting with this lateral side of the. They are having connection to the forebrain, which is essential for the sense of the smell. And it is having two parts: this is the cerebrum and the diencephalon. And see this diencephalon. This is the rhomboidal shape, which is above the midbrain. This is the rhomboidal shape, which is above the midbrain. This is the diencephalon, and it is divided into parts. The upper part is called as hypothalamus. The lower part is the rhomboidal shape, which is present inside it, is called as thalamus. This is the diencephalon. This diencephalon, what is the function of this? Diencephalon means what is the hypothalamus function means it controls these pituitary glands. It is under the pituitary gland. Mainly, what is the function of the forebrain means it is the site of intelligence. If you want to think, if you want to do anything, if you want to do mental ability, if you want to do a sum, if you want to solve the puzzle, the forebrain should be active. The forebrain should be active. This is under our control. Voluntary actions. It will show voluntary actions. Whereas remaining two, the midbrain and the hindbrain, shows the they control the involuntary actions. Next, midbrain connects to cerebellum and pons of hindbrain. What it will do? It maintains the involuntary actions of the body, and hindbrain it connects the cerebellum. And having the connection to the cerebrum and above medulla oblongata, and maintain posture of the body or position of the body. Medulla oblongata is useful for the cardiac. It is responsible for the giving signals or taking signals from the cardiac and respiratory organs from the body. This is the structure of brain and the functions of the brain. which is very, very essential to know about it. Because without brain signals, we can't do anything. Voluntary actions and involuntary actions. What are voluntary actions? The actions which are in our control are called as voluntary actions. That means if you want to listen the lesson, that means you have to sit. That you want to play, you want to kick the ball, you want to play in the playground, you want to write, you want to read, all these things are the voluntary actions. You want to eat, you want to drink, you want to play, you want to run, all these actions are voluntary actions. What are the involuntary actions are taking place in the body? Means involuntary actions means unknowingly, without taking signals from the brain, without giving signals from the brain, we are doing some actions. Those actions are called as involuntary actions. For example, heartbeat, circulation of blood, these are the involuntary, blinking of eyes, these are involuntary actions, children. Not only the voluntary actions and the involuntary actions, a special system is there that is called as reflex actions. What is a reflex action? What are reflex actions? Suppose if you are going on the road, if you are walking on the road, suddenly a bus is coming, otherwise a car is coming, what do? Suddenly we lift our head and we saw the car. Do we go in front of the car? No, we will not go. If you go, means what will happen? An accident will happen. Then what do? Suddenly we move. Suppose if you are walking on the road, as seeing this side and this side, suddenly we saw a sharp object on the road. Then what do? Do we step on the sharp object? No. We will remove from the move aside from that sharp object. All these actions, if you touch the hot object from the stove, what do? We'll catch it we'll hold it, the hot object? No, we'll not hold it. Then what do? We'll take out the hand from that hot object. All these actions, without controlling the brain, what do? We'll do such type of actions. Suddenly, means those actions are called as reflex actions. Reflex actions. So, how many nerves are there? The nerves. 12 pairs of cranial nerves are there. And 31 pairs of spinal nerves are there. 1 pair of cranial nerves are there. And 31 pairs of spinal nerves are there. Once again, I'll explain the structure of brain, children. This is the structure of brain, and brain is divided into three parts: the forebrain, the midbrain, and the hindbrain. And cerebral hemispheres are there. Foldings will be there. These are the gyri and sulci. The elevations are called as gyri, and the depressions are called as sulci. And then see. Here the grey matter and white matter will be present. What is grey matter and what is white matter? Previously I explained about here the nerve cell. Two parts are there, mainly the cell body. To the cell body, the dendrites are there. And to the axon, the myelinated sheath. The axon is covered with the myelinated sheath. Wherever the cell body is present, that is called as grey matter. The axon sheath, the myelinated sheath, is called as white matter, which is present on the brain. The cell bodies will be present at the periphery, at the end of the brain, at the edge of the brain. These are the periphery cell bodies. Mostly the dendrites will be present towards the periphery. It is called as the grey matter. Wherever the axons leave at the center, that is called as white matter. And then what do they do? Gray matter and white matter, it is identified on the brain where are the dendrites and where are the axons on the brain and the body parts, remaining the body parts, because only we can identify what are the dendrites, what is the cell bodies of the nerve cell, and what are the axons of the nerve cell. Means we can identify because of the myelinated sheath, which is present, which is covered by the axon, Mostly, how many cells are there? Brain is more than 10 billion cells. Nerve cells also more than 10 billion cells. They communicate with each other, they coordinate with each other, and will perform our day-to-day life. Because one thing is there, children, we are having the skeletal system is there, the musculatory system is there. Not along with this is two systems. If you want to function these two systems properly, means the nervous system should be coordinate with each other, and they have to, the brain should send commands to through the spinal cord. Then only we'll do the from spinal cord to various parts of the body. Then only we can do our the work perfectly, and we can perform our metabolic activities perfectly.
నేను మాత్రం మా ఇద్దరు పిల్లల్ని క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందించే ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరి స్కూల్లో మాత్రమే చదివిస్తాను. ఇలా అన్ని ఉన్న చోట మన పిల్లల్ని చదివిస్తేనే వాళ్ళకి మంచి భవిష్యత్తు ఉంటుంది.
నాకు అన్ని నెంబర్ వన్నే కావాలి. అందుకే నా పెద్ద మనవరాల్ని అన్ని వసతులతో క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందిస్తున్న స్కూల్లోనే జాయిన్ చేశాను.
ఏ స్కూల్ సార్ అది?
ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరి స్కూల్. క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లో నెంబర్ వన్, కల్చరల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ లో నెంబర్ వన్, స్పోర్ట్స్ లో నెంబర్ వన్, క్యాంపస్ లో నెంబర్ వన్.
అది
మీ పిల్లల బంగారు భవిష్యత్తుకు మాది బాధ్యత.